Hello! I guess Papa is in the house today, no? So, we're gonna talk about Papa John's today, and it's actually having its earnings report, and things are looking dire here. When I was living in the US, and it's been a few years since I left, I was actually eating quite a lot of Papa John's. It's one of my favorite pizzas up there. And I'm actually interested in seeing that the company is going down 20% after earnings. And I wanted to examine the financials, see what the company has been doing, and also make a discounted cash flow model that we're gonna be visiting at the end of the video. So stay tuned, we're gonna talk a lot about Papa John here, and actually see whether it actually makes sense for us to buy the stock right now. So first things first, you will see here that the company stock price has been climbing a lot lately. And there's a little bit of a decline lately, as with pretty much all stocks in the stock market. Or a lot of them. So it used to be like 140, sort of. The next thing we wanted to check, it's still actually up the last year. The next thing we want to check is the outstanding shares, which have been declining, and this is awesome to see. And actually, they have been declining a lot. So I guess Big Papa was actually buying shares back and went from almost 50 million here to 33, 31 here. Now they're actually selling a few more, I suppose, trying to capitalize on the fact that the stock price went higher. So you would potentially expect that. But, and actually, this actually just got updated here. So we're looking at a lesser of a decline now as I'm actually making this video. It was actually 20% later, earlier. So, what's happening here in terms of Papa John's? You will see that the next 12 months PE is looking to be 31, but we don't have a current one, and we will see what happens with the financials of the company here. So the next thing we're going to examine is the income statement, and we are looking at a market cap of almost 4 billion for Papa John's. So it's obviously not a massive company. It's not a super small one, but it's not a massive one either. And revenues, as you would kind of expect for a pizza chain, I suppose. You can't be expecting exploding revenues, right? So still, I mean, 11% and 14%, I wouldn't consider that bad at all for a pizza chain, really. And the gross profit is also actually getting higher here. Likewise with actually even more than the revenue. And what about the net income? So the net income of the company here is actually the same as it was in 2017, which is not great, but look at the headwinds that the company had in the previous 3 years. So compared to that, actually it's doing better. And so I like to see this number here. And what about the balance sheet of the company? Two things that are important here. The total liabilities sitting at $1 billion right now, almost, actually a little bit more. And the total equity is actually negative over here, and that's not great, because it means that we have more liabilities than assets. And so if you take a look at the assets, they are actually less than the liabilities. And so the company has a minus in equity, and that's always a red flag. The company is actually not keeping any assets from operations. And this has been the case for many, many years so far. Plus, this company is actually paying dividends, which we will examine as well. And so without any equity at hand, that can be a little bit sketchy, really. So let's take a look at the cash flow. So the cash flow of the company, you will see the cash flow from operations here is positive, which is obviously a good thing, but we want to examine the free cash flow and how much of that is kept for, for free cash flowing within the company. Companies investing a little bit, not too much. It's mostly capital expenditures. What about financing? Financing here is actually negative, so it looks like they are paying back some debt here. Yeah, that's a good thing to see. I'm assuming they used a lot of the money that they got from the issuance of common stock, the latest one, and maybe they paid some of their debt back. What about the free cash flow? The free cash flow is actually positive here, so it means that they're actually using their income well. I mean, they don't have insane net income here, and it looks like their capital expenditures are kept. Under a balanced situation here, and so they are actually making money from operations. So because free cash flow, remember, is cash from operations minus capital expenditures is what it is. And so if you subtract for example 52 millions here from 211, you're gonna be getting the free cash flow that you're seeing here, 160 almost million dollars. And what about the multiples of the company here? They're actually very low, which means that the company's enterprise value compared to sales is fair, really. Anything below 3 is probably fine here. Profitability, though, the return on equity is in the minus, and that's something that I really don't like to see. This basically gets the amount of equity and plus debt that the company is deploying in order to make money, and this shows that this is negative. This is a negative number. It's a bad thing. The total equity is actually in the minus here, just because the company doesn't have equity, but they do have debt. And so with minus in equity, you're getting a minus number here, and that's a bad thing. Now, we're gonna take a look at the free cash flow and make a model here for the company. And you will see here that at least the free cash flow is positive. And sitting at, let me find it here in the cash flow statement, it's actually sitting at 160 million here. So I have prepared a 5-year free cash flow summary here, basically, which I'm using for the projection for the next 10 years. And this company is a riskier company. It's actually seems to be losing money. So if I am to invest in them, I want a good return on investment here, just because I'm risking a lot. So I'm gonna go for 15% for my returns here for the company. And the free cash flow to use, you will see that the 5-year average growth is a little bit skewed here, just because the company is going up and down and then has some steep increases and all that. You can't expect that to happen for 10 years, 100% increase in free cash flow. That's very unlikely. I'm gonna go conservative, and I may not even be that conservative in with my number here. I'm gonna go like 10%, and again, this could actually be too much, frankly. You may want to try estimates for like even 5% for this one, and a perpetual growth rate of the company of 1% here. And I have also pre-populated the outstanding shares in million. You will see that the price per share to pay here is sitting at $55 almost per share. And currently, we're going to be sitting at 94 when the market opens. So we're far from what I would want it to be. And frankly, if I were to buy the stock, I would probably use something like a 5%, be even more conservative for my free cash flow growth. Because I don't know what the company is going to be doing in the next few years, really, and I don't expect this free cash flow to continue be, you know, to continue growing in the like 10% or so. But 10% could be, but maybe more than that, it may be a little bit too much actually to expect from a company. But still, I mean, we're far below what we would want to be even with 10%, right? And I could also use a smaller discount rate, which I probably wouldn't use for this company. But even then, I'm getting a $65 estimate here, and again, we are very low when you compare it to the current price, which is going to be around 95. So hopefully that makes sense and gives you some ideas about Papa John's. Let me know what you think about the company. Are you looking to buy? Do you hold it? Actually, I'm sorry about that. I forgot to examine the dividend. It's also very important. I'm sorry about this one. You will see that the payout ratio is sitting at 40-41% here, and it's actually paying 1.3, it looks like, right now, percent. But this kind of payout ratio is not very worrying, but I wouldn't be surprised if they actually cut it down, because they don't make a lot of free cash flow really, and they don't have any equity, so this can be at risk. So bear that in mind as well. Thank you for watching this video. I hope you enjoyed. If you did like it, take a look at this video that I made earlier, and it's about Alibaba's earnings, in case you are interested in Alibaba. And I will see you in the next one, guys. Bye bye.